Today's live stream will begin in a few moments. Don't go away. Today's live stream from England will begin shortly. Today's live stream will begin in a few moments. Today's live stream will begin shortly. Today's live stream will begin in a moment. Are you ready? Are you sitting comfortably? Okay, let's get on with it. So here we are then, 5 minutes past 2 o'clock on a Saturday. This feels very strange because I'm sitting with you. Well, in fact, I'm standing at the moment. For those who know me very well, you will know that I prefer standing up. Some people like sitting down. However, I am one of those strange people who enjoys standing all the time. So here we are then. We are now live in a slightly different place. Normally I'm in the studio. Sometimes I'm walking around. However, today we are in a very unusual place. I am actually on top of the roof. There is a famous song called Up on the Roof. So I feel now like singing that song. Up on the roof is where I am today, talking to you live from England. Yes, here we go again. You can see that the weather is quite nice today. We have some lovely weather. It is breezy. There is some wind in the air. You can hear the birds singing because many of the birds now are feeling very happy and excited because it is the mating season. So lots of birds now are trying to find a companion. They are trying to find someone to settle down with, to find a beautiful girl or a beautiful boy and build a nest, lay some eggs and raise some little chicks. So it is definitely springtime. You can see lots of the blossom already coming out on the tree. So if you look carefully, you can see there is lots of blossom on my damson tree. So the weather is looking nice as well. I've just realised that the sun is now out. So this morning it was very cloudy, but now the sun has come out and everything is looking rather nice. So can you hear the birds? The birds sound very happy today because they are feeling a little bit amorous. The word amorous. If you feel amorous, then it means that you feel a little romantic. You want to find a lover. You want to find someone to spend your time with, maybe. So the birds are now looking for love. I think it's fair to say. Here we go then. Where are you, Mr. Duncan? We can't see you. We can't see you on the camera. Where are you? Why are you hiding from us, Mr. Duncan? Okay, I will show you where I am now. Here I come. Are you ready to see the horror that is me? Here I come, everyone. I'm a-coming onto your camera. Are you ready? Maybe you are not ready. Maybe you are not prepared for what is about to happen. Here we go. After three. One, two, three. Oh, there you are. Hi, everybody. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? Well, are you happy? I hope you are feeling happy today. Yes, I am now standing on the roof of my house. For those who don't believe me, I am actually on the roof. So you can see I'm high up above everyone else, looking across the beautiful countryside, the landscape behind my house where I live. So now finally you can see my beautiful face or otherwise. So hello everyone. Hi everybody. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? Are you happy? I really, really hope so. I hope you are feeling good today. I am not too bad. I'm all right. I had a nice sleep this morning. I was in bed until about 11 o'clock. And then I went into town with Mr. Steve and we bought some bread. So we went to our favourite shop in Much Wenlock and we bought some lovely bread. And then we came back home. And then I prepared my live stream and here I am now up on the roof of my house. It isn't very windy today, so I think it is safe to stay on the roof. Now, normally I don't come up here because quite often the wind is very strong and it can be a little unsafe and a little dangerous to stand on your roof when the wind is blowing. So today I've decided to come up on the roof. The sun has come out. Even though it keeps disappearing. Thank you, Christina. Thank you very much to the live chat. We have a live chat now. You can actually join in with the live chat whilst I stand here on my rooftop. Can you believe it? Can you believe that this is even possible? One of the things I love about modern technology is that it allows us all to stay in touch. So that's one of the reasons why I really like it. Hello to Christina. Hello to you on the live chat. Don't forget, you are more than willing or more than welcome to get in touch. Hello to Dung. Xin Chao. Hello and Xin chào to all those watching in Vietnam. I know I have a lot of people watching in Vietnam, so hello to everyone watching there. Hello, flower. Ooh, hello, flower. I bought a pizza to eat. I didn't make it myself. It is not homemade. That's all right. In these strange times, sometimes we have to do things differently. So I don't think it's wrong. Maybe sometimes we have too many things to do. Perhaps you are taking part in a lot of things, especially at home. So maybe you are looking after your husband, and maybe you are looking after your wife and your children. So all sorts of things are probably going on around you. So you are probably doing all sorts of things. So if you want to make something that is not homemade, something that you've bought from the shops, I think that's all right, to be honest. Let's not forget, these are very strange times that we are living in. Hak Lao says, are you standing on the roof? I am. I am high up on the roof above my house. You can see the view behind me looking across the landscape. It is quite a nice day here in England today. Not too bad. You can see there is some blue sky. Oh yes, look, above my head there is blue sky. Going over my head there are also some clouds. So you can see there is a lot going on around me. Not only the birds, but also you might hear some of my neighbours in their gardens. They are doing some maintenance. They are taking care of their gardens at the moment. So can I say a big hello to everyone? Thanks for joining me today. Thanks also for joining me every day, because I will be with you every day during March and April. So in March, I try to be with you every day. But in April, I will definitely be with you every day. So I can promise today, tomorrow, and the day after that, and for the rest of April, I will be with you live on YouTube, because that's what I want to do. So we are all sharing the same situation. You are in the same situation as me. I am here, isolated. Fortunately, I am able to enjoy some of the views around here, so I thought I would share them with you, and I hope you don't mind. Hello to the live chat once again. Hello, Mr. Duncan from Patrick. Hello, Patrick, watching in Vietnam once more. Someone in Vietnam. Mr. Duncan, you look so tall. I am quite tall. A lot of people are surprised when they meet me because they realise that I'm very tall. It is my pleasure, Mr. Duncan, to see you. Dorota or Dorota, nice to see you as well. Hello from The Hague, Mr. Duncan. Have you ever been to the Netherlands? I have. I've been to the Netherlands three times. One of the times I went to a friend's wedding. So some friends of ours, they decided that they wanted to have their wedding in Amsterdam. So we went all the way to Holland, we went all the way to the Netherlands to enjoy a wedding. And we had a great time, even though we almost missed the plane. There is a great story that goes with one of my trips to Amsterdam. We got to the airport for our return flight back to the UK. We actually got there late and we almost missed our plane. And they had to actually hold the plane until we got on. And I still remember getting onto the plane and all of the passengers were staring at us. They were giving us very horrible looks. They were giving us very dirty looks because they were angry. And they knew that because of me and because of Mr. Steve, the plane could not take off. So yes, I felt very embarrassed by that situation. So I do have some memories of the Netherlands. Hello, Bommo. Hello also to Mika. Mika is here. Can I greet you, Mika, with a big wave and a nice happy hello as well. Thank you for joining me today. Thanks also to Lena is here. Lena is back. Nice to see you here as well, Lena. Great to see you back with us on the live stream. So I was in town this morning with Steve and we were buying some bread. However, there were quite a few people in town. I was surprised. There were many people walking around the town centre. However, they were all keeping a safe distance from each other. So many people were standing very far from each other. So we went into the baker's shop and they had lots of plastic. So they had plastic in front of them. So you couldn't get near to them. You couldn't actually touch them or hold them. Not that you would want to normally, you see. You don't normally go into the shop and grab the assistant and put your arms around them. It doesn't normally happen. Hello, Sarah. Sarah Fahad. Nice to see you here as well. Yes, it is a lovely day here in England. The sun comes out sometimes and then it goes back in, unfortunately. Hello to Florence. See what I mean? There's always one person who has to start making a noise with their power tools. Hello also to Nguyen Viet Long. Mr. Duncan, you look like Mr. Bean. Really? Do I look like Mr. Bean? I've never noticed that before. No one has ever said that to me. Do you ever use your mask when you go outside? No, I don't. So here in England, we don't really wear our masks. We don't wear masks at all. However, most of us are very careful. We don't get close to each other. So we make sure that we stay very far apart from each other. We make sure that we stay very far apart. We keep our distance, which means that we stay far apart. Hello, Christina again. Yes, they say that the social distance must be around 8 meters. Apparently, they keep changing the advice. Well, one of the things that is confusing most people at the moment is all of the advice that the experts keep giving us. So every day they seem to change the advice. Needless to say, it is causing a lot of confusion. A lot of confusion. Hello to Bomo K. Kainajot. I think you are also watching in Vietnam as well. I'm having difficulty seeing my screen because the light is shining in my eyes. So let me just see if I can make that better. I'm having difficulty seeing my little screen. I have taken a course on Coursera. Oh, I see. Is that a website? So there are lots of great websites around and some of them are offering free trials. So during this strange period of time when you are stuck in your homes, maybe you can find something on your computer, something that will give you a little bit of entertainment or maybe something you can learn from. So there are many websites, including mine, by the way. I'm here now doing this live. Can you believe it? So I'm now live on YouTube outside on my roof, having a lovely day. Very nice. Not too bad. Thank you very much. So people are not wearing masks. We are just keeping our distance. So here in the UK, we have been told that we don't have to wear masks when we go outside. However, we must stay far from each other. So we can't get too close. We can't get too close. Hello to Printo Francis. Hello, Printo. Nice to see you here as well on my live stream. For those who don't know who I am, my name is Mr. Duncan. I teach English on YouTube. I've been doing this for a long time. A very long time. Do you know how long I've been doing this for on YouTube? Ever so long, a real long time. Hello, Sergio again. How are things with Boris and Prince Charles? Well, Prince Charles is all right now. He's okay. However, poor Boris is still in isolation. It would appear that he's not very well, unfortunately. Beta! Hello, Beta. Yes, you are right. I've been doing this on YouTube for 14 years. Thank you very much. Not a lot of people realise that. And that's the reason why I keep mentioning it. Hello also to Nana Cat, who also says 14 years. Lena says, I am taking 120 hours TOSIL certificate course on the International Open Academy website. Oh, well, there you go. You are finding something to do, something useful, and something that will help you improve your English. So you are preparing for your TOSIL exam. Do you live in paradise? Asks Juan Jose. Do I live in paradise? Sometimes it feels like it, and sometimes it doesn't feel like it. It is very nice here when the weather is good. However, when the weather is not so good, it's not so nice. So sometimes during the winter, it can be very unpleasant here in the countryside. However, when you have a day like this, everything is quite nice. Everything is lovely. Hello to Rakesh. Hello to you as well. Belarusia. Hello, Belarusia. I have missed you during the past 2 or 3 live streams. I haven't seen you for a while. Where have you been? I would imagine you've been busy with your family. I think so. But nice to see you here. Yes, always make sure you keep your hands clean. Wash your hands regularly during the day to make sure you stay well. And that's the one thing I wish for everyone. I hope you stay well, stay happy. And during this strange period of time, I hope you find something nice to do. I hope you find something good to keep you occupied. I can't speak English, but how are you tonight? Thank you, Nguyen Car. Thank you very much. I'm okay, thank you very much. At the moment, it is 25 minutes past 2 in the afternoon. Don't exaggerate in washing your hands. Don't do it too often. Well, they say you should do it maybe 3 times a day, but especially if you've been outside. If you've been outside, you must always wash your hands when you get back home. Definitely, I think so. I have flies, by the way, buzzing around me. There are lots of flies at the moment, flying around, feeling very exciting and very happy. Unfortunately, they keep flying into my face. So all of the flies are buzzing around, and it's very distracting, to be honest. Mr. Duncan, can you tell us the name of the hill behind you? You mean that over there? That is called the Wrekin. Wrekin. W-R-E-K-I-N. Wrekin. So there is the Wrekin Hill over in the distance. And that is a famous landmark here in Shropshire. So the place I live is called Shropshire. That is the area. And I live in a little place called Much Wenlock, a very quaint English town. If you ever think of typical English, a typical English scene, you might actually think of maybe a small village or a small English town. So I actually stay in a small English town. And as you can see, it is in the countryside. I think one of my neighbours is very busy in their garden. They are doing some work in the garden. Hello also to Rakesh again. Hello to Emina. Vitas is here as well. Hi, Mr. Duncan, again. Hi to you as well. Super Learner. Hello, Super Learner. Did you read my email? I have received a lot of emails over the past couple of days, so I am trying to read all of them. So I'm not sure if I've read yours. Maybe I have, maybe I haven't. However, I do I have a lot of emails that I have to read, as you can imagine. I do get a lot of people writing to me from around the world. Thank you very much. Can I say thank you to Petros as well? Thank you, Petros, for your very kind donation to my PayPal. Thank you very much. So you are welcome to send small donations to allow my work to continue forever and ever, because I do all of this for free. So this doesn't cost you anything. You can actually sit in front of your computer and you can watch all of my lessons. You can watch me talking to you live. You can even join in on the live chat, and it will cost you nothing. Everything is free. Palmyra has joined us. Also, we have Luis Mendez. Hello, Luis. That's very nice. It's great to see so many people on the live chat already. Thank you very much for joining me. I've been with you for 27 minutes exactly. Ooh. We have a few interesting things to look at today. I thought we would look at some unusual and maybe some funny English phrases and words. So what I'm going to do today is show you some unusual, strange, maybe even funny English phrases and English words. So that is one of the things we're doing today. We won't just be standing here looking at the sky, even though the sky is looking rather nice today. Would you like another look at the sky? There it is. The sky above my head. Mr. Duncan, I hope the situation is under control. Things... I want to say things are going well, but they're not. Things are not going particularly well. However, it would appear that many people are observing the new rules about safe distancing. So I think a lot of people are observing and following all of the rules and guidelines. So yes, so I think a lot of people are actually trying to stay on the right side of the law. Here in the UK now, if you are caught doing something or being outside where you are not supposed to be, or maybe you are with a group of people, they will actually fine you. They will actually tell you to pay some money. And in some cases, it is a lot of money. Can I see the background? Well, if you want to see the background, you are more than welcome. Does it make you happy? If it makes you happy, it makes me happy. Here it is. So here is the background. A little bit of countryside on a Saturday afternoon. Normally, I don't come on Saturday. So normally, I'm not here with you on Saturday. However, because we are all locked in our houses, we all have to stay at home. So that's what I'm doing. That's exactly what I'm doing. So we have some things to show you. Oh, look, I walked around my garden this morning and I want to give you something. Can I give you something nice? Here, just for you, a beautiful daffodil from my garden. And this one is a white daffodil. So this isn't yellow. So normally daffodils are yellow. However, this one is white. It is a white daffodil. They are very beautiful flowers. They look so delicate, and they have a very sweet scent. So the scent is very sweet indeed. Look at that. So there is my lovely daffodil. Sadly, some of the daffodils now are starting to close and they are starting to die, unfortunately. I always feel a little bit sad when the daffodils start to die, sadly. So there is a lovely daffodil just for you. I picked this from my garden just for you. I hope you like it. A lot of people ask me, Mr. Duncan, when you are making your video lessons, when you do your live streams, what do you use? So I thought it would be interesting. I thought I would show you something that I use when I'm making my lessons, and sometimes I use it when I'm doing my live streams. So let me show you something.
Oh, Mr. Duncan.
What is it you are going to show us? So this is one of my cameras that I use when I'm filming, and this camera is very old. I bought this camera many years ago. It was around 2008 I bought this. So this particular camera is now over 12 years old. 12 years old, this camera. And I've used this for many things. I've used this to film my turkey lesson. Have you ever seen my lesson that I filmed in Turkey? And that particular lesson was filmed on this little camera. Can you believe it? So this little camera has been to lots of places, including Malaysia as well. So in 2014, I made an English lesson in Malaysia. And I also made one in Turkey. And this is the camera that I used. A very simple camera. So it isn't a professional camera. This is the sort of camera that you would buy from your shop, your electric shop. So this particular camera has been to many parts of the world. But it isn't special. It's just your average camera. So I bought this in 2008. And it cost, I can't remember how much this cost. It was around £350. So this was £350 way back in 2008. So this is a high definition camera. It has, you can see it has a little slot there. Can you see the slot? And inside you put a little memory card. So this memory card goes in there, and then you can record all of your videos onto that card. So this is a very simple, basic camera. However, I have used this in many ways. I have used this during some of my recorded English lessons, and also I used this during my live streams as well. So quite often you will see this camera bringing you some of the lovely pictures from my studio window. So this is the actual camera that I use. So quite often when I'm looking across the landscape from my studio window, this is the actual camera that I'm using. So this one now is very old. A lot of people might say, Mr. Duncan, that camera is old-fashioned. It is out of date. However, it still works. It still works very well. So what I'm trying to say here is sometimes you don't have to spend a lot of money to achieve things that look good. So a lot of people think you have to go out and buy the most expensive camera in the world. But to be honest with you, quite often you don't have to spend thousands and thousands of pounds. Sometimes you can spend just a little bit of money and get a really good camera. So I love this camera. I think this camera might be my most favorite piece of equipment that I use. So this is often used during my live streams and when I'm recording some of my lessons. I love this camera, and it's been everywhere with me, all over the place. You can see it's made by Canon, and it's an HF 100. They don't make them anymore, so this particular camera is now obsolete. So you can't even buy this anymore. However, if you go on eBay, there are people selling these cameras for a very good price. So I absolutely love this camera. If you want to buy a second-hand camera, sometimes you can get some real good bargains. I'm not going to say which websites, but I'm sure you know the websites I'm talking about. So this particular camera, it works very well. It produces stunning pictures. And I think this might be my most favourite piece of equipment that I have for all of my filming and all of my work making my English lessons. So there, I hope that's interesting. Something unusual, because I don't normally show you my equipment. Ooh, Mr. Duncan. I can't believe you said that. So here is a piece of equipment that I use. It's old, but it still works very well. And I love it. I love this camera so much. I want to marry it. I want to marry this camera. One of the things I don't like about this camera is it doesn't have very good zoom. So the zoom only goes to 12 times. So really, for the things that I like doing, I normally like 20 times zoom. But this only has 12 times zoom, unfortunately. So if you want to zoom in on something, this is limited. So it doesn't give you very good zoom, unfortunately. However, for normal applications, it's a very good camera. So if you can get one of these second-hand, maybe on one of those websites where people are selling their old things, let me just tell you, you will get a very good camera indeed. The Canon HF100. You can't buy them anymore. They don't make them anymore. They are now obsolete. So you zoom in and you zoom out. Unfortunately, this particular camera does not zoom in very far. So if you want to take some really good pictures, if you want to zoom into something, then you need a camera that can do that. And quite often, they are often expensive cameras, very expensive cameras. So I love this camera. I love you very much. Please, never leave me. I can hear the birds singing, Mr. Duncan. Thank you, Dwee Lam. Yes, the birds are very excited at the moment. They are all around me because they are looking for their soulmate. They are looking for someone to build a nest and lay some eggs with. I have to use a Samsung Galaxy S20 and then I can zoom in by 100 times. Yes, I've seen that, but unfortunately it is only, I think it's only on the S20 Ultra. So you have to buy the very expensive version of the Samsung S20. So not the average, not the normal one. I think you have to spend even more money if you want the 100 times zoom. I'm not exactly convinced that you can actually have 100 times zoom on a mobile phone. I'm not convinced. Let's take a photo of the birds with my old camera. Yes, it's a good idea. Well, the wonderful thing nowadays, of course, is everyone has a camera. Everyone. I have a camera, you have a camera. So at the moment, perhaps you are watching this live stream on your phone that has a camera. So I think taking photographs can be a very good thing. It is a great way of remembering things. I do like creating memories with photographs. How many hours can you record with that camera? Well, you can put lots of different sizes of memory card. So maybe if you have very good quality, maybe you can record, 2 hours or 3 hours of very good quality. So it really depends on what type of quality you want to use. What type of quality? Where is the pheasant? Where is the pheasant? I don't know where the pheasant has gone. The pheasant has disappeared. During the lockdown, do you live stream every day? Rohith, yes. During April, I will be with you every day. So I'm here today and I will be here tomorrow. Don't forget, tomorrow, Mr. Steve will be joining us tomorrow. Mr. Steve will be joining us tomorrow on the live stream, 2 p.m. UK time tomorrow. Yes, I will be with you every day. I'm doing a live stream every day. I just hope you don't feel bored. I hope you don't say, oh, Mr. Duncan. Oh, Mr. Duncan, why do you keep coming onto the internet every day? Oh, it's so boring. I hope you don't think that. I am here for just a few moments because I want to come here to give my like. Thank you very much. And also to greet my dear teacher and classmates. Thank you, Guadeloupe. It's nice to see you here. I know a lot of people at the moment have things to do. They are looking after their families. They are at home. Maybe they have to take care of many people during this strange period of time. At the beginning of your live stream, I think I heard the pheasant. Yes, I think you're right. So just after I started today's live stream, I did hear the pheasant. He was calling in the distance. And of course, at the moment, my pheasant has a girlfriend. Oh, yes. So he's feeling very happy and excited. Anna Peaker says, in these weird times, I've noticed that nature has taken back its spaces because people are at home and are not disturbing them. This is right. There is a small town in England where the whole of the town has been taken over by goats. Have you seen it on the TV? So many news reports have been made about this particular town in the UK, and it has goats, all these goats are just walking around the town everywhere. It's quite amazing. Ah, dear. Hello also to Zayed or Ziad. Hello to Ziad. I think I had this question the other day. What's the difference between quarantine and lockdown? Well, lockdown is when you stop people from moving around from place to place. So maybe you will lock down a town. So you will tell everyone that they have to stay in that town. They have to stay there. They can't go outside the surrounding area. So maybe you have the border of the town. You can't cross the border. You can't go out of the town. You can't go out of the city. So lockdown is what happened in China, in Wuhan. They had a lockdown there. So people couldn't leave the city. So people couldn't come in and people couldn't go out. So they were locked down. And then when we say quarantine, we mean a person who is being put aside for medical treatment. So maybe a person who has a very dangerous or contagious illness or a disease. So yes, you normally put them in a special room where they will receive medical attention. We often say that we put them into quarantine. So quarantine can be used as a verb and also a noun. So you are in quarantine. You quarantine something. You quarantine a person. You keep them away from other people. From other people. Hello to Irene. Welcome to England. Welcome to my little live stream from the top of my roof. Oh, I just heard the pheasant. Did you hear the pheasant? I think the pheasant is nearby. I just heard the pheasant. Hello, Schwan. Hello, Schwan. Nice to see you here today. Hello, Mika, once again. Also, Amna. Hello, Amna. Nice to see you here as well. Yes, I'm talking to you live from the roof of my house on a very nice day. I must say, the weather is not too bad. It is very warm. Apparently tomorrow, it is going to be even warmer. So today is warm. Tomorrow will be warmer. Even hotter tomorrow. So it's quite nice. Hello also to Benji. Hello, Benji Slod. Hello to you. Nice to see you here as well. Yes, a lot of people are watching in Vietnam. Can I say once again, hello to Alex D and also all of his students. Thank you for joining me here today. So far away. And yet, we are so close. Isn't it strange? Isn't it funny? Technology sometimes is amazing. And as you know, I always get very excited by technology. I think technology is brilliant. I really do. Hello also to Christina. I'm glad to hear that you are doing well. Yes, I'm okay, and I hope you're okay as well. You are my new teacher. I want to listen to something about English. Well, the English language is now a language that is spoken by many people around the world. As I always say, English is an international language. Many people like to use English when they are communicating. It has become a common form of communication. So that's one of the reasons why English is so popular. Yes, we can be like a family with this technology. Well, that is the thing I always say. I always say that my class here on YouTube is like a big family. So I'm here with you, and you are here with not only me, but also everyone else as well. So it is like a big community. It is like a big family, or maybe a big classroom. B Chewit asks, I need to see the sky. Do you? So there is the sky above my head. There is some blue sky, and also there are lots of clouds as well. So there is a little bit of blue sky, not much, above my head. I'm back now. Christina says, Duncan, you are great because you keep us company every day. I try my best. Kwong Do Man says, I know you through Alex D, and I think it is very good advice. Thank you very much. It's nice to know that there are so many people coming here for the first time. If it is your first time, please say, Mr. Duncan, it's my first time here. Corrie. Hello, Corrie Torres, who says, I am new to your channel. Great. Hello also to, it's going very fast now. So many messages are going by. Are you safe, Mr. Duncan? Asks Valor. I am safe. I know a lot of people are worried when I go outside, but I can go outside as long as I'm not near other people. So as long as I don't go close to other people, I'm okay. So I'm here at the moment on the roof of my house, all alone. So yes, to answer your question, I am safe up here. Hello also to John Williams. Hello, John Williams. You are not the famous composer, John Williams, are you? Maybe not. Thank you also to Fazian, who says, you are handsome. I'm not sure about that. But thank you anyway. H.Y. Kevin Kim. Hello, Kevin Kim, watching in South Korea. A big hello to you. A big hello to you, and my thoughts are with you as well. Mr. Duncan, you really helped me a lot. I appreciate that so much. Thank you, Remixy. Hello, Remixy Dudek. That's okay. It's my pleasure. I love doing this. You might describe me as an English addict. I love English. I love speaking English. I love talking about the English language. And best of all, I love teaching English and helping you at the same time. So, yes, that's what I like to do. Mr. Duncan, in the Middle Ages, it was Latin that was the spoken language. Even after 1,000 years of the fall of the Roman Empire. Yes, well, of course, Latin and also ancient Greek, we often use that in English nowadays and also in other languages as well. So yes, you are right, you are right. Latin has influenced the English language a lot, quite a lot. Especially when we talk about science and nature, Latin exists everywhere. You speak good English. Well, I like to think so. I like to think that I speak good English. I try my best. Grace Chin is here. Hello, Grace. It is a Chinese festival today, the Qingming Festival. The festival takes place in Malaysia, but now we have to stop all of the events during this moment of controlled order. Yes, I've heard in Malaysia they are taking it very seriously. So many places are closed. People have been told to stay at home, like many places around the world at the moment. Why are you a salty man and very cute? I don't know. I've never thought of myself as cute. But thank you anyway. Thank you. Salty. I'm not sure if I'm salty. A person who is salty might be a person who has been around for many years and has been to many places. So we talk about a salty person as a person who has had a lot of experience. I suppose I've experienced many things in my life. Some of them are good and some of them not so good. So yes, we all have experiences in our lives. But of course, as you get older, you collect your experiences. And as you get your experiences and you collect them, they change your personality. Maybe they change the way you behave, or maybe they change the way you think. So that is one of the reasons why I am a big believer of experience. I am a very big believer of getting experience. Whatever it is, wherever it is, whatever you are doing, always try to get as much experience as you can. Do you think the will be gone soon? I'm not sure. I don't think anyone knows. I am definitely not a medical expert. So from my own point of view, it looks as if people aren't sure. Everything is unknown. As I said to Steve this morning, most people now are living from day to day. So they are living from day to day. So when I wake up in the morning, I open my eyes with a big smile and then I enjoy my day, and then at night I go to bed and then I wake up the next morning and I do the same again. So I am living from day to day. That's all you can do. So that is what most people are doing at the moment. So you can't really make any plans. I have no plans at all. So I have nothing planned. I have no holidays. I have no trips. I'm not going anywhere. So unfortunately, I am stuck here. So I would like to be here with you, if that is okay. Is that all right? I hope so. I really do. All we have to do is wait and see. Christina, you are right. All we can do is wait and see. That is all we can do. We have no choice. Would you like to see some interesting words from the English language? I love English and I really love words that are strange and weird. So we're going to have a look at some strange phrases and some unusual, very unusual words. Would you like to do that? I hope so, because that's what I'm about to do. Oh, by the way, guess what? Before I do that, I have my Jaffa cakes. Yes, I went to the shops on Friday night. No, not Friday night, Thursday night. I went to the shops on Thursday night and I got some Jaffa cakes. So look at that. I have some lovely Jaffa cakes to keep me company. The problem is there are only 10 in the box. There used to be 12. They used to have 12 Jaffa cakes, but now they only have 10. Thank you, Mr. Pheasant. They only have 10. I think that's terrible. Anyway, they are only £1. Look, that is the price. 10 Jaffa cakes for £1. Are you going to eat your Jaffa cakes now? No. No, I'm not going to do it now because I have something more important to show you right now. So here we go. Some interesting phrases. I love these phrases. So some of these are phrases, some of them are proverbs, some of them are also sentences, like collocations maybe. So when we talk about collocations, we talk about words that are used in a certain order that don't happen by chance. So here's one. Here's a lovely phrase. I love this one. Some of these might be new, some of these you may have seen before. There we go. So there is the first one. A little bird told me. If you hear something from another person, maybe someone tells you something, maybe a friend tells you a secret, and then you tell someone else what that secret is. You might say, I know because a little bird told me. So there is a great phrase that we often use in English. A little bird told me. A little bird told me. I heard it from another person. So a person told me something, and now I am telling you. A little bird told me. A little bird whispered in my ear. Suddenly it's getting very windy. It's getting very windy. I don't know why. Here's another one. Oh, here's a nice expression in English. Maybe you have heard this before, maybe not. A turnip for the books. A turnip for the books. When we say something is a turnip for the books, we mean an unexpected thing that happens, or some fortune or something good that happens unexpectedly. So maybe you have a surprise. Maybe suddenly you win some money, or maybe suddenly your boss gives you a promotion. You can say that it is a turnip for the books. It is something unexpected, something nice that you weren't expecting. A turnip for the books. A nice thing that happens unexpectedly.
Ooh.
Very nice. I like that one. Something you weren't expecting. A nice thing is a turnip for the books. Here's another one. Oh, so this one now is negative. So this particular one is negative. A fly in the ointment. A fly in the ointment is a well-known phrase in English. It means something that comes along and spoils the thing you are enjoying. So maybe something that is nice and pleasurable, and then something comes along and spoils what is happening. They spoil it. A fly in the ointment. Something comes along to spoil your enjoyment. A fly in the ointment. So when we say ointment, ointment is something you put on your face or maybe on your skin, something you put on to make maybe your skin feel better, or maybe if something has damaged your skin, you will put some ointment. Ointment. That's a great word, isn't it? Ointment. A fly in the ointment. Ziad has a very interesting phrase. Blood is thicker than water. Blood is thick. Thicker than water. That is also a good one, yes. So we often say that family is more important, or maybe the connection or the bond between family members is very strong. We often say that blood is thicker than water. You are right. You are right. Mr. Duncan, can you please say sure? I want to listen to the pronunciation. Thank you, Sunshine. Sure. Sure you can. Sure. Sure. Why not? Sure you can. Can I come to your party tomorrow night? Sure you can. Sure. Of course. Sure you can. No problem. Yes, ointment is often something you put on your skin if it is damaged, or maybe you have something that is infecting your skin, maybe something that has irritated your skin. You can put ointment on your skin. I've just realized that I'm touching my face. You see, I'm not supposed to touch my face. They keep saying, Mr. Duncan, stop touching your face. I will try my best. Here's another phrase, a very interesting one. Make waves. Make waves. Make waves. If you make waves, it means you create trouble. You create a problem for someone. So a person who makes waves is a person who creates problems. A person who always causes trouble makes waves. So a person is making waves. They are creating a difficulty. They are making things bad by their actions. They are doing something that is causing problems. They are making waves. So in this sense, make waves means create problems, create difficulties. You are causing trouble. You make waves. I like the next one, by the way. I like this one. Sometimes you might be sitting in the local pub having a nice drink of beer, and then someone will come up to you and they will offer you something for sale. They will say, hey, guess what? I've got some nice watches here. Some nice Rolex watches. Do you want one? Only £10. Do you want one? Do you want a Rolex watch? Only £10. Wow, that's amazing. What a bargain. However, there is a chance that it fell off the back of a lorry. So I love this expression. So if we say that something fell off the back of a lorry, it means there is a good chance that it has been stolen. It fell off the back of a lorry. So if someone comes up to you and offers you something, maybe a lovely expensive phone, maybe they say, would you like to buy this iPhone? Go on, £20, that's all. It only costs £20. You might say, oh, I don't think so. I don't want it. I'm sorry. I think it fell off the back of a lorry. I think maybe you stole it. Maybe the thing you are selling has been stolen. You must always be careful when you buy things, especially if you buy things from a stranger in the street. Oh, here's a nice one. Here is a nice positive one for you. A sight for sore eyes. A sight for sore eyes. Sore eyes. When we say a sight for sore eyes, it means a welcome sight, something that makes you feel happy because you saw it. Maybe you see a beautiful woman. Maybe you are waiting for a beautiful woman to come into the room. And there she is. She walks in and she's really beautiful. She looks just like Sharon Stone. She does. Sharon Stone in 1981, by the way. She looks just like Sharon Stone. She's ever so nice. Ever so nice. And you think, wow, she is a sight for sore eyes, which means that she is beautiful. Something beautiful. Something beautiful. A sight for sore eyes is something you see that is beautiful and it makes you feel good. It makes you feel happy. It makes you feel excited. Ooh, ooh la la, ooh la la. That's French, by the way. Here's a good one. I like this one. Hello to Dashrath. Hello, Dashrath Pandit, who says, hello, I am new, Mr. Duncan, in the live chat. Can I say hello to you and welcome to my lovely live stream, live from the roof of my house in England. I'm talking to you now live from the rooftop of my house. Wow, very unusual. Here's another one, a well-known expression. Quite often we will use this here in England. Spend a penny. Does anyone know what this means? If you spend a penny, what does it mean? Does anyone know out there in YouTube land? If you spend a penny, what does it mean? If you spend a penny, we often use this in British English. It is something we have to do, something we have to do from time to time. Excuse me, I have to go and spend a penny. I have to spend a penny. If you spend a penny, what does it mean? If you spend a penny, it means you have to go to the toilet. Ooh, so I like this. In British English, if someone says, I have to go and spend a penny, it means I have to go to the toilet. You are saying it in a nice, polite way. Excuse me, I have to go and spend a penny. It is a euphemism So we often use words or phrases to hide something that we might be embarrassed by. So this is a very good example of something we call a euphemism. Euphemism. So when you say that you will spend a penny, it means you are going to the toilet. And the reason why we say that is many years ago, if you wanted to use a public toilet, you would have to put a penny in the door to make it open. So that's the reason why we say spend a penny. If you spend a penny, it means you put a penny in the door so it will open. However, nowadays it is much more expensive. It isn't a penny anymore. I think it's about £1.50. Much more expensive. So if you say that you are going to spend a penny, it means you are going to the toilet. Ooh. I shouldn't really talk about that. I shouldn't, because if I think about it, maybe I will feel as if I need to spend a penny. So I don't want to think about it. I can't think about it. I don't want to think about it at all. Apparently in Euston Station, Euston Station, it is 20p. 20p. So if you want to go to the toilet at Euston Station in London, it is 20p. Although every time I go to London, quite often it smells as if people have been going to the toilet everywhere. Oh, I got it the wrong way round. Mika says you don't have to pay to use the public toilets in Japan. Very nice. Very good. I like that. Here's another good one. I was distracted then by Mr. Steve. As keen as mustard. So here is another one. As keen as mustard. If you are as keen as mustard, it means you are very enthusiastic about something. You feel very interested, excited. You want to know more. Please tell me more. I am as keen as mustard. I am very interested. So if you say that you are as keen as mustard, it means you are excited. You can't wait to find out what is happening. You can't wait to get involved. You are as keen as mustard. Mustard. As keen as mustard. You are very enthusiastic. Mustard. Mustard is a type of seed, and you can crush the seed and you can make it into something you put on sandwiches, or maybe you have it with food. So mustard is a type of relish. It is something that you put on your food, and quite often it is very hot. So mustard can be very hot. It can burn your mouth. Between you and me, I love mustard. I like it very much. I don't know why, but I am keen as mustard about mustard. Here's another one. If you are doing something that you are not used to, maybe something that is new, maybe something that you've never tried before, maybe something that you haven't experienced, maybe you are new at something. Maybe you are new at your job. Maybe you are in a strange place that you've never been to before. Perhaps you are in a strange place. We might describe you as a fish out of water. If you are a fish out of water, it means you are in a place that you are not familiar with. You are in a strange location, a strange place. You are a fish out of water. So this expression means you are in a place that you don't know, or maybe somewhere that you are not familiar with. You are like a fish out of water. Valor says, I think mustard is better than mayonnaise. I do like mustard, I must admit. Mustard goes very well with ham. So if you have a sandwich and if you put ham and then you put mustard on the ham, oh, it is so nice, very delicious. So yes, a fish out of water is to be in a place or a situation that you are not familiar with. Maybe something that makes you feel upset or nervous. You are a fish out of water. For those who are wondering, maybe you have just clicked on my face by accident. My name is Duncan and I teach English, and we are talking about all sorts of things today, not only English. You can talk about anything. Maybe you want to talk about the current situation in the world. Lots of things happening. Here's another one. Maybe a person who has said something or has to admit that they made a mistake. Maybe a person who said something or done something, they did something that they now feel that they have to apologize for. Maybe a person who said something that is not right or incorrect. They said something that was false. Maybe they have to apologize. We will often say that they will have to eat humble pie. So if you eat humble pie, you have to apologize. You have to make a very solemn, sincere apology. You have to swallow your pride and eat humble pie. It means you have to make an apology for something you said or did. You have to eat humble pie. When can I use these phrases? Well, you can use them in a situation that may arise or may happen. Here's another one. Oh, I like this one. Flogging a dead horse. If you flog a dead horse, it means you are doing something, you are trying to do something, you are trying to continue doing something that is no longer interesting or no longer useful. You are trying to carry on doing something that has already ended. You are trying to make use of something that is no longer useful. You are flogging a dead horse. Flogging a dead horse. You are trying to get use out of something that is no longer useful, unfortunately. Maybe you have been doing something for a very long time, and maybe it is something that no one has any interest in anymore. You are now flogging a dead horse. By the way, the word flog means hit or beat. You are flogging. Flogging a dead horse. Here's another one. I mentioned the birds earlier. I mentioned the birds, and many of the birds are preparing to mate. They are getting ready to find a companion, and then they will mate, and then they will have some little chicks. Isn't that nice? Hanky panky. Have you ever heard of this phrase? The phrase is hanky panky. If you have hanky panky, it means you have a little bit of ooh la la, a bit of ooh la la, a bit of ooh, let's get together and have a little bit of fun. Hanky panky. I think my boss at work is having hanky panky with his secretary. I think my boss at work is having a little bit of hanky-panky with his secretary. I think so. Yes. Oh, hello. Good night, everyone, from Vietnam. Bye, Vietnam. See you later, Vietnam. Catch you later. Hello also to Sunshine again. Mr. Duncan, what does it mean? Does it make sense? Does it make sense? Does it sound logical? Does it sound like something that might be real or true? Something makes sense. So if you make sense, it means you can be understood. So does it make sense? Do you understand it? Do you understand what I'm saying? Does it make sense? So make sense means something that can be understood. Yes, that makes sense. You must practice English every day. Yes, Mr. Duncan. That makes sense. That makes sense. I understand what you are saying. To see a man about a dog. Maybe you have to go somewhere to do something, but you don't want to tell the other person where you are going. You don't want to tell them what you are doing. So instead, you will say, I have to go now, unfortunately. I have to go to see a man about a dog. So you are not telling them where you are going. You are not telling them why you are going. You are just saying, I have to go. I have to go to see a man about a dog. So you are saying that you have to go, but you are not telling them why. Maybe you have a little secret that you don't want to tell them. To see a man about a dog means to go somewhere, but you are not telling them where you are going. Please can you say hello to my little daughter? Her name is Asil. Hello to Maruwen and your little daughter. Hello, Asil. Hello, Asil, from Mr. Duncan in England. Hi, are you okay? Are you having a good day there? I hope so. Kwani Cichlid asks, which one do you love, Justin Bieber or Ed Sheeran? I think neither of them, to be honest, neither. please, I want to join your lesson, says Ali Yilmaz. Hello to Ali Yilmaz. Welcome to my live lesson from the roof of my house. I'm standing up here, but don't worry, I'm not going to jump. Things aren't that bad. I always try to keep myself happy. Sometimes I like to come here and talk to you and spend a little bit of time talking about the English language. But don't worry, I'm not going to jump off the roof, okay? So don't worry, I'm okay. Not too bad, thank you very much. I'm not too bad. I hope you are good today. What are you doing during these strange times? Because we are living through very unusual times, don't you think? I think so. We are living through very strange times. Juan Jose asks, what about Frank Sinatra? I was talking about Frank Sinatra the other day. I don't think he's a good singer. He wasn't a good singer. I wasn't a big fan of Frank Sinatra. Can you please read out my name? My name is Abdi Kwani. I hope I pronounced that right. Sometimes I try to pronounce your names and sadly I don't get them right, for which I apologise very much. I am watching your videos, says Sravan. Hello, Sravan. Nice to see you here as well. Welcome to my live stream. Something unusual today. I'm standing on the roof of my house. In fact, I am right above my studio. So underneath my feet, beneath my feet, is my studio. So I'm right on top of my studio. Hello to... Can you please read out my name? It is Robert. Robert Pedden. Hello to Robert Pedden. Interesting. I like your name. Very interesting. Do you like Pavarotti, Mr. Duncan? Yes, of course. Pavarotti, probably one of the greatest singers ever. Certainly as far as opera is concerned. Yes, I think so. You are right. Mark Venus says, I discovered your channel last week because I needed to make some videos and your videos have inspired me. Cheers, Mr. Duncan, and stay safe. Thank you very much, Mark. That's very kind of you to say. Some people do start making their own videos because they've watched what I've done. So, yes, always tell yourself, if Mr. Duncan can do it, I'm sure you can as well. It's so boring listening to all of your names. Please don't waste time. Okay. Is it really a waste of time saying hello? I'm not sure. I thought I was being very friendly, to be honest. Hello to Ibrahim. I hope you will read the Holy Quran and the Book of Fundamentals. I have actually read most biblical books. Can you believe that? So I've had the Quran in my hand. I've read it. I've also read other religious texts, the Bible. Read that. I've had a look at all sorts of religious beliefs and religion. So yes, I've looked, I've explored, I've looked around. One of the things that I mentioned earlier is experience. So when you experience things, you experience all sorts of things, all sorts of things. So you experience opinions, you experience what people think. You gather information. So that's what I like to do. I don't just listen to one thing. I always listen to lots of things, many things. So I don't listen to one thing. I listen to many things and then I decide for myself. I hope that answers your question. Hello, Anna. Can you say hello to my son, Iggy? Hello to Iggy. I like your name, by the way. Iggy. Hello, Iggy. He has loved your channel and has watched it for a long time. So hello, Iggy from England. Thank you very much. Anna says, I love it when you say my name and I really appreciate that very much. Well, that is the reason why I do this. So the reason why I do this is because it gives me a chance to share my love of the English language and hopefully you can learn something, but also you will have a chance to write on the live chat. So really, this is like a conversation. This is like a conversation taking place over the internet. Mr. Duncan, you are doing great work with your class. It's so nice to hear you mentioning our names. Thank you, Beatrice. That is very kind of you. Mr. Duncan, would you please explain the word... Sorry, can I read that again? Because it's gone. Wait there. Mr. Duncan, would you please explain the word pretentious for me? Oh, yes. A word that a lot of people use. Maybe you want to appear intelligent or wealthy or sophisticated. Maybe a person who always tries to appear like something they are not. We can describe that person as pretentious. So a person who likes to show off, a person who is always trying to display themselves in a particular way, to make themselves appear artistic or intelligent. We can say that they act pretentious. You act in a pretentious way. Pretentious. So a person who does things to make themselves appear like they are not. The thing they are not, they try to appear to be. A pretentious person. Here in the UK, we have a lot of people who are pretentious. They try to make themselves appear wealthy, or maybe they try to make themselves appear intelligent. Maybe they sit on the train in the morning when they are going to work and they have a copy of a very intelligent book in front of them. However, they're not really reading it. They just want to appear intelligent to all the other people on the train. But really, they're not reading the book. They're not reading it at all. I haven't had my breakfast yet, says Elijah. I'm sorry to hear that. I'm sorry to hear that you haven't had your breakfast. You must have your breakfast. Some people say that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. Some people say that. They say breakfast is the most important meal of the day. What is the difference between twirl, whirl, and swirl? Thank you to Rick Sanchez. Rick San. I have a feeling, are you Rick Sanchez? I think you might be Rick Sanchez from Rick and Morty. Maybe. What is the difference between twirl, whirl, and swirl? Well, to be honest with you, they all have very similar meanings. So whirl, if you whirl, it means you go round and round in a very elegant way, like this. So you will whirl. Give it a whirl. You go round and round. Whirl, whirl. Maybe you have a very strong wind that will whirl around and around. We often describe that as a whirlwind. So whirlwind is wind that blows around and around, like that. Whirlwind. So you whirl. Whirl. And then the other one, twirl. Well, if you twirl, it means you go round again, once again. Twirl. If you twirl, it means you mix two things together, maybe. You move something around and around. You twirl something. Perhaps you can move around like this. Twirl. Like this. Mr. Duncan, can you give us a twirl? Here is my twirl just for you. See? So there, I gave you a twirl. Twirl. Can you please say, Helen is... Can you please say, Helen is a mag? I hope I'm not saying anything rude there. Helen is a mag. It is for my mum. She has lost all her limbs and is in quarantine. I know she's watching because she always talks about you. Thank you very much. Hello, Helen. And I hope you feel better soon. Please, can you tell me something about... Thank you, Dashrath. Well, I'm sure that there is nothing I could say about it that you haven't heard already on the news. Have you noticed when you turn the news on, all they're talking about at the moment is the same thing. It's all they're talking about. All they are talking about. So I don't think there is anything I could tell you that people are not already saying, to be honest. Yes, you could just watch the news. Watch the news. I'm sure the news will have all the information you need. Yes, it is better to talk about life and also happiness. I think so. Sometimes you have to try and be happy. Sometimes you have to look at the positive things in life. As I often say, sometimes you have to make the best of a bad deal. Sometimes you have to make the best of a bad deal. So maybe something that is going wrong in your life, maybe something that is difficult, maybe you are having a difficult period of time. You try to make the best of something. You try to make the best of a bad deal. Every cloud has a silver lining. Look above my head. There are lots of clouds above my head, but I always try to look on the bright side. I try to look on the positive side. I try to see the good things that are happening as well. So every cloud has a silver lining. I like that expression a lot. I like it. Every cloud has a silver lining, even though sometimes things don't go the way you wanted them to. Sometimes things do not go as you planned. You can always look on the bright side. As I said earlier, try to look on the bright side of your life. Sometimes it's hard, I know. Sometimes it is very difficult to see the bright side of something. However, quite often you can look, you can see something positive, even during a bad situation. Look on the bright side. Always look on the bright side of life. A-do-do-do-do. Sorry about that. There is light at the end of the tunnel. There is light at the end of the tunnel. There is always light ahead in the distance, even if you can't see it. There is light at the end of the tunnel. Light at the end of the tunnel. And, as I showed you just by accident, remember you are not alone during this time. I am in the same situation as you are. We all have to share this situation. We have to be in the same situation together. So I am having to stay here and you are having to stay there. However, during this very strange period of time, we can all enjoy this very weird time together. We are all in the same boat. We are all sharing the same situation. We are all in the same situation. So yes, remember, you are not alone. We are all going through the same thing. Hopefully every day I will be here during April to keep you company. So I will try my best to be here every day and keep you company for as long as I can. What is an affirmation? If you affirm something, it's a little bit like a thing that you maybe preach or maybe something that you say that has a meaning that will bind you. You affirm to reassure yourself, to make sure you know that something is real. You affirm. We often talk about experiences in life that are life-affirming. So maybe you have a wonderful experience in your life that makes you look at things in a different way. We can say that thing is life-affirming. It affirms your view of life. It makes it stronger. It solidifies your feelings. What does reverse mean? Reverse means go backwards. If you reverse, you go backwards. You slowly go backwards. You start to go away. Reverse. If you reverse, you go back. Back. Reverse. Back. You go forward, you will come toward someone. You go back, you reverse, reverse. I hope that answers your question. I will be going soon, by the way, because I've been here for a very long time. Mr. Duncan, you haven't drunk any water. Okay, I'm going to have a little drink of water. So I will show you something nice, and then I will have a little drink of water. That's better. I have just refreshed my throat. It was getting a little dry, so now I can rejoin you again. There we are. Welcome back, everyone. It's Mr. Duncan here on Saturday afternoon. Saturday afternoon here in the UK. I hope you are okay where you are. I hope you are feeling good where you are right now. Is this your house? Yes, it is my house. I'm standing on the roof. Part of my house is what I'm standing on at the moment. So yes, I am standing on the roof. That's good. Yes, I'm standing on the roof, and yes, this is my house, to answer your question. Can you recommend any books? Well, there are many books that you can read. This is a good time, by the way. This is a very good time to find maybe a good book, maybe something to read during this time. So I like reading books about people's lives. I am very interested in finding out how people lived their lives, especially people who accomplished lots of things during their life. So I am always interested in how people lived their lives. Famous people, successful people, quite often I will read the story of their lives. And nowadays, you have many ways of reading books. So you can go to the library. You can also use your tablet device as well. So you can read books anywhere, even on your computer and on your iPad or on your tablet device. So actually reading is something that people are doing more and more. Although I have a feeling that people are not reading books as often as they do. However, people are now reading on their phones. What the hell is that noise? That noise, I don't know, maybe it's... Is it me? Is it my voice? That horrible noise you can hear is me. Please, can you tell me about in your country? Well, a lot of people have been affected by it. There have been, sadly, a lot of fatalities. Many people are now infected. I can say that in the area where I live, there aren't many people who have been affected by it. So I think I'm okay. I'm all right. I'm fine. I am 100% well. I am fit. And I feel okay. Thank you very much. What time is it here? It is now 10 minutes away from 4 o'clock. 10 minutes away from 4 o'clock. I will show you just to prove. It is 10 minutes away from 4 o'clock right now. Let's have a look at some words. I love the English language. You may have noticed. I like English a lot. I am crazy about the English language. I am very crazy about the English language. Hello there. Can I become fluent in English at 25 years old? Yes, you can. If you spend enough time, if you really want to do it, if you really want to learn English, you can. Is it a stream for just idiots? Oh, thank you, Sergio, for that. I'm not sure about that. Maybe I could say something really sarcastic there, you see, but I'm not going to. I'm going to rise above it. Adwar, hello, Adwar Ahmed. Can you please say my name? Yes, Adwar Ahmed. Nice to see you here as well on the live stream. Thank you, Winnie. Hello, Winnie Whitney. Winnie Whitney. Did you enjoy my song yesterday? I sung a beautiful song to Winnie Whitney yesterday. Did you enjoy that? Was it nice? Did it bring a tear to your eye? A lot of people say that my singing always makes them cry. I think so. There are many comments here. I can't keep up with the comments. There are so many comments coming up on my screen. I cannot read them all. I'm sorry. Oh, here's something. Here's something I've got now. I've got something in my hand. Oh, would you like to see what I've got in my hand? I've got something in my hand. Would you like to see it? Okay, then. Funny English words. Oh, Mr. Duncan, we did not know that was in your hand. Yes, there it is. Funny English words. There are some strange words in the English language. Very strange words indeed. So we are going to look at some strange English words, and then I am going. I am going. So some strange English words, and then I am going. What do you mean, good? How could you say that? Do you know Michael Jackson? No, I don't know him personally, but yes, I know his songs and some other details. Squander. Oh, now there is a good word. I like that word. That is a great word. There are some words in the English language which really just express so well the meaning. And this is one great word. Squander. I love that word. I could say that word all day. Squander, 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 squander. Mr. Duncan, okay. Mr. Duncan, okay, we understand. Can you please tell us what it means? Squander. If you squander something, it means you waste the thing, quite often with money. So you waste things. You waste money. You waste time. You waste your energy. Squander. So there are people who have lots of money and they will spend their money all the time on all sorts of rubbish. They will spend time on all sorts of rubbish. So we say that they squander their money. Squander. So if you squander, it means you waste, you throw your money around and you waste it on rubbish. So many people who have money will often squander their money. They will spend it recklessly. They will spend their money on all sorts of rubbish. Squander. I think that's a great word. I don't know why. Some words really sound like the thing they mean. And I think squander is a really good one. I like that one. Here's another word. I like this one. Here's another word. It is a little word, a very short word. However, I think it's also a very fun word as well. Stoop. Stoop. I like this word. If you stoop, it means you move your body down. You bend your legs and you stoop. Maybe if you are going to the toilet, you might stoop. You might stoop as you poop. So when you poop, you will often stoop. So some people might stoop when they poop. Stoop. You get down. Quite often you will bend your knees and you will lower your body. You will stoop. Can you see what I'm doing? I'm actually stooping. I'm trying to stoop so you can see it. So stoop. I'm going to stoop. Stoop. I like that. That's a good word. An action. So that particular one is a verb. Stoop. Do you stoop when you poop? Here's another one. I like this word. Twiddle. Twiddle. You move. You move things. Twiddle. Maybe you twiddle your fingers. Twiddle. A person who is feeling nervous or anxious might twiddle their fingers. You might twiddle your fingers if you are feeling anxious or nervous. Twiddle. Twiddle. That's a great word, isn't it? Twiddle. Twiddle. You twiddle your fingers. You twiddle. You play with something in a very nervous way. Twiddle. It's the pheasant. Pheasant. Hello, pheasant. I've missed you. I've missed the pheasant. Did you hear that? The pheasant just came to say hello on my live stream. Hello, Mr. Pheasant. Mr. Pheasant is very happy at the moment because he has a girlfriend. So I twiddle my fingers when I'm nervous. Here's a good word. I can actually see the pheasant. He's over there. I can see you watching me. Here's another good word. Lummox. Lummox. It is not a peacock. It is actually a bird called a pheasant. Pheasant. So here's another word. Lummox. Lummox. A person who is careless or clumsy. They move around in a clumsy, careless way. We can describe them as a lummox. Lummox. That's a great word, isn't it? Lummox. So you might describe a person who is careless and they move around in a careless way. Lummox. A person who is careless when they are moving, when they move around. They don't take care as they move about. Lummox. A person is a lummox. You lummox. Here's another one. I saw a lummox yesterday. Did you see a person and they were being very careless? They were not taking care. A person is described as a lummox. I love that word, lummox. There it is. Here's another word. This is something that I do. Would you like to see the word? This is something that I do. Even in my job, it is something I do. And here it is. Hello, Yasir. Hello, Yasir. Nice to see you here. Hello to Noderbek. Hello, Noderbek, who is watching in Uzbekistan. That's very nice. Sravan says, my data is over. Bye, everyone. Bye, Sravan, and hope to see you again very soon. Here is something I do in my job. This is a thing that I do all the time. It's a great word. Prattle. Isn't that... Oh, I like that. Prattle. Prattle. A person might prattle. Prattle. If you prattle, it means you talk endlessly. You talk all the time. You don't stop talking. You just prattle. So prattle means talk. You talk and talk and talk and talk. You prattle. You talk endlessly. You don't stop talking at all. Quite often, a person who prattles is a person who just talks about nothing. Maybe they talk nonsense, or maybe they just talk endlessly about nothing. Some people say that's what I do. Yeah. That's not very friendly. That's not very nice. How could you say that about me? I always try my best. Here's another one. Oh, I like this one. Why don't you go around to teach us your neighbours and how they look like? Yes. Can I just say something? Most people do not want to be on camera. The average person does not want to be on camera. They don't. Most people are shy. They don't want to be filmed or photographed. So that is the reason why you will never see my neighbours on my live streams because most of them are very shy. They don't want to appear on camera. So I hope that answers your question. Here's another one. Oh, I like this one. Do you know what this means? I will pronounce the word for you. Fisticuffs. Fisticuffs. I like that word. Fisticuffs. Have you ever heard of this word? It is a great word. We use it quite often in British English. You might hear the word used, fisticuffs. Have you ever heard it? If you do, it means that you are having a fight. Fisticuffs. Come on. Like that. So that is fisticuffs. If you are having fisticuffs, it means you are having a fight using your fists. Like that. So I hope that answers your question. For those who don't know what this means, it means to fight. You fight. You have a fight using your fists. Kapow. Kapow. Like that. When I was a kid, I had a lot of fisticuffs. I bet you did. I think you did. Where do you live in England? I live in a place called Much Wenlock in England. And that's where I live. Fisticuffs. Fisticuffs. Fight with your fists. We could also say punch up. You might have a punch up. Punch up. If you say punch up, it means you have a fight using your fists. Here's another one. Some strange English words. That's what we're looking at right now. Here's another one, a very strange English word. It is a real word. For those who are wondering, it is real. This is a real, genuine word. Kerfuffle. Kerfuffle. Have you ever heard of the word kerfuffle? The word kerfuffle means chaos, confusion, fuss. A person is creating a fuss. They are creating a chaotic situation. Kerfuffle. So this is another good word that really does sound like the thing that it defines. Kerfuffle. Kerfuffle. Chaos. Hustle. Hustle and bustle. Things are happening everywhere. Sergio says, are these rarely used words? No, they're not rarely used. We use these quite often. Kerfuffle. So kerfuffle, people will use this word. Yes. I'm using it now. There is a lot of kerfuffle in the world. Kerfuffle. Chaos. Busy. Hustle and bustle. So yes, there is a lot going on at the moment. Kerfuffle. Kerfuffle. Words that are very strange, but they are used. So yes, I'm not making these words up. These aren't fake words. These are real words. I've never heard that before. No? Well, now you have. Shenanigans. There is another word. I love that word. Shenanigans. Isn't that great? When we say that there are shenanigans, shenanigans. Shenanigans means something that is going on that people are not aware of. Maybe you are doing something in secret. Maybe you are doing something without other people knowing. You are creating some mischief behind people's backs. You are doing something maybe secretive, something that other people do not know about. There are shenanigans. Someone is doing something behind your back. They are doing something. There is mischief. Shenanigans. Shenanigans. An activity that isn't good, says Marina. You are right, yes. That is a good way of describing it, I suppose. What does supercalifragilisticexpialidocious mean? It doesn't mean anything. It is a made-up word. It has no meaning. There, I answered that one quite quickly. Codswallop. Here's another word. This is a real English word. It exists. It is real. Codswallop. Some people might say, Mr. Duncan, your English lessons are a load of codswallop. Yeah. Codswallop. Something that is useless, pointless, rubbish. Something a person is saying that has no meaning. Or maybe something that is useless. Codswallop. Codswallop. What a load of codswallop. What a load of rubbish. What a pointless thing to do or say. What a load of codswallop. Codswallop. I love that. Isn't that great? And that is a real English word. It is a real English word that people use. Codswallop. I just think that's fantastic. God. I'm enjoying myself too much today. Mr. Duncan, you must calm down. You are enjoying yourself far too much. Here we go. Now, here's a word that you will recognize. There is a beautiful bird called a swan. Swan. Have you ever seen a swan? They are beautiful birds. However, we can also use the word swan as a term for a person who is moving around. They are traveling from place to place, having a good time. They are enjoying themselves. They are having an enjoyable time as they move from place to place. You swan around. A person who is swanning around is a person who moves from place to place. They are having an enjoyable time. They are traveling around extravagantly. They are having a wonderful time. They swan from one place to another. You might describe your neighbour. Maybe your neighbour goes around the world on a cruise. So maybe they take a cruise ship. Okay, not at the moment. They are not taking a cruise ship at the moment. But they might. They might. But you might say, oh, my neighbour is swanning around the world on a cruise. Swanning. So it is a great expression that means to move around, maybe move from one place to another, swanning around the world. You swan from one place to another. Swan. So quite often we are using this as a verb. As a verb. You swan from one place to another. Just like a swan. So when a swan is moving around, it moves in a very elegant way. Swan. I like that word, by the way. It's very interesting. Would you like to swan around the world, Mr. Duncan? Yes, I would. I would love to swan around the world. I really would. Did you hear that? Once again, that was that was the bird. Did you hear the bird? Did you hear Mr. Pheasant say hello? You are probably wondering what I'm doing. Trying to get something out. Ah, that's better. You see, this is my paper, you see. I was trying to get my paper out of my pocket, but it wouldn't come out, unfortunately. Does anyone want a Jaffa cake? Would you like a Jaffa cake? Who wants a Jaffa cake? Look, you get 10 Jaffa cakes for just £1. That's incredible. Incredible. 10 Jaffa cakes. £1. You could also say quid. Quid. So when we say £1, we say 1 quid. So that is a slang term for British money. So £1, we might say 1 quid. Is the box full? Yes, it is. This box of Jaffa cakes is actually full. It is. It's a full box of Jaffa cakes. And as you know, I love Jaffa cakes very much. So this one is full. It is. Mr. Duncan, please can you stop? You are giving us too many words. Okay, I will stop now. If you ask me, I will stop. If you've had enough, if you can't stand any more, I will stop. I have showed you a lot of words today, by the way. Don't forget, you can also watch this live stream again and again and again, as many times as you want. Oh, and by the way, if you like it, give me a thumbs up. If you like this, give me a thumbs up. Mr. Duncan, we like it. So click that button. Click it. Keep clicking it. Click, 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 click. Click the button as many times as you can. You have a very strong will with those Jaffa cakes. I do. I like Jaffa cakes. We all have to have something in our life that we enjoy. We do. So in my life, I enjoy English and Jaffa cakes. That's it. I'm a simple man. I have simple needs. I like teaching English and I like eating Jaffa cakes. I think that's fine. That's okay. It's quite harmless. I'm not hurting anyone. Do you enjoy eating pizza? Yes, I do. I love eating pizza. Would you like to see the... Oh, there he is. There is... There's the pheasant. Can you see the pheasant? There is the pheasant. That is the pheasant that you heard earlier. Can you see the pheasant? He's walking off. He's going away. I can see you. I can see you, Mr. Pheasant. Yes, I can see you. We can see you. So there is the pheasant. So that was the bird that was making all of that noise earlier. And there is the female. The female is there as well. So the male and the female are together. So that is his new girlfriend. I wonder what her name is. So there they are, the pheasant. So the pheasant has a girlfriend. And there they are. So you can see the male pheasant and the female as well at the same time. So there they are as they walk off together. Well, they don't appear to be together. Maybe they've had an argument. Maybe they've had a fight. Who knows? Maybe. Well, that was unusual. Did you see that then? Did you see the little pheasant walking along with his girlfriend? I hope you enjoyed that. And I hope you've enjoyed today's live stream. A lot of people are joining us now. Hello, everyone. Hello to the UK. Hello also to you, wherever you are watching in the world. This is Mr. Duncan live from England. English, England, and me, Mr. Duncan. I hope you are having a good day. Christina says the pheasants are so beautiful because they are walking around together. I think so. The pheasants are lovely, especially the male. I think the male pheasant is very beautiful. During the mating season, the pheasant will have a beautiful long tail, and he uses his tail to attract the girls. It's true. So what the pheasant will do, he will walk around and he will show his beautiful tail to all of the other female pheasants. And then the females will get very excited. They will say, "Ooh, look at that over there. There is a beautiful male pheasant. A beautiful male pheasant." Thank you, Mazda. I hope you've enjoyed today's live stream. It's been interesting. We've looked at lots of things. For those who are wondering, I am now standing on the roof of my house on a beautiful spring-like day here in the UK. Thank you very much to Aya. Yes, it's very kind of you. Have you ever been to Morocco? I've always wanted to go to Morocco. I've never had a chance to do it. Hello, Pappy. Hello, Pappy. I've never seen your name before on the live chat. Hello, Pappy. Nice to see you here today. Lovely to see you here. By the way, if you like Jaffa Cakes, maybe where you live, somewhere, you might find some Jaffa Cakes where you live. Who knows? So, can you please change your view, Mr. Duncan? Okay, I have changed my view. There we go. Is that better? So here is another. Did you see that? What happened then? There was a dog. There's a dog at the back of the house, and it actually chased the pheasant away. Did you see the pheasant go by? That was very dramatic. Okay, I've changed my view now. You can see me looking in a different direction. I hope you are enjoying this moment of time. Thank you, Anne. Anne Khan, thank you very much for joining me today on the live chat. Lots of things going on today. It's been very dramatic, hasn't it, really? It's been very dramatic. For those who want to see another view, can you please show us your view again, Mr. Duncan? Okay, there it is. So there is the view from where I am standing right now, and I hope you are enjoying it. It is a beautiful day here in the UK, and there you can see what I'm seeing at the moment, the beautiful landscape here in Shropshire. So for those who are watching at home, for those who are watching around the world, don't forget, you are not alone. We are all in a very similar situation. Thank you, Berlim. Berlim is going now. Thanks, Berlim. See you later. I will be back tomorrow, by the way. For those who are wondering, you can catch me here live on YouTube every day during April. So I will be with you every single day during April, from 2 p.m. UK time. And there now you can see the lovely view from the top of my house. And look, you can see all of the lovely clouds in the sky. Everything is looking very nice. Everything is looking beautiful here in England. So if it is your first time watching, please say hello. You don't have to be shy. I know there are lots of people who like to join my live streams. However, they never say hello. They always stay very shy. So don't worry. You don't have to be shy. You don't have to worry. If you want to say hello, you are more than welcome to do so. I'm quite a friendly person, really. Hello also to George. George Theocharis. Hello to you as well. Thanks also to Vu Njo, who is watching in Vietnam. We have Vietnam watching. Hello, Vietnam. Hello, Mr. Duncan. You are very lucky to have that view in front of yours. Thank you for showing it. You are welcome. What is the filling inside your cake? I think maybe you mean Jaffa cakes. So inside the Jaffa cake, there is orange. Very nice. So orange is the flavour that is inside the Jaffa cake. Can you hear the birds? They sound very excited. Will Steve be with you tomorrow? Yes, he will. I'm back tomorrow. I will be with you from 2 p.m. UK time. And I will say this again, for those who don't know, I am going to be with you every day. So every single day during April, I will be with you. Do you have any series for children? My daughter is about 8 and she loves to watch your live streams, but I'm not sure she could capture everything you are saying. Well, I don't make lessons for children. However, quite often, because of my colourful character and because I tend to show things that are very colourful and bright, a lot of people do like to watch my lessons with children. So it is up to you, really. Your camera is very good, Mr. Duncan. Thank you very much. I am using my little phone. So this is my phone you are watching me on at the moment. Can you believe it? So I'm actually using my little tiny phone to talk to you at the moment. It is my old iPhone. Very old. So this isn't a new iPhone. This is actually a very old iPhone, for those who are wondering. Thank you, Beatriz. Thank you, Noemi. Thank you very much for all of you today. I'm quite overwhelmed because so many people are actually now joining me, and it is nice to see you here today. Thank you very much. I do appreciate your company. I do like being here with you, and I hope you like it as well, wherever you are watching in the world and whatever you are doing right now. Thank you, Catherine. That's very kind of you. Thank you also to RHS. Thank you all for your wonderful company today. So 2 p.m. tomorrow, I will be here on YouTube live. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up before you go. Please, can you give me a lovely thumbs up? And also, you can share as well. So please, I will give you one last look behind me. For those who are wondering, Mr. Duncan, where are you? So here is the view behind me one more time. For those who are interested, and maybe also for those who are not interested. There is the view right now behind me. I hope you are enjoying it. Look at that. We are having a beautiful day here in the UK. And there is the beautiful sky above my head. And there is the not so beautiful sight, which unfortunately is my face. Thank you very much for your lovely comments. Mr. Duncan, your cap really does suit you. Thank you very much. Yes, for those who are wondering, I am now talking to you live from England, the United Kingdom. Hello also to UK, le noob. I love that word, noob. If a person is new at something, If they are doing something that they haven't done before, we will say that they are a newbie. Newbie. Have you ever heard that expression? Newbie. You are a newbie, a new person. Thank you very much to Florence. Thank you very much also to Grace. Thank you to everyone. So many people have joined me here today. I feel very happy to have you with me. And I hope you feel the same way as well. Do you have to wear a face mask, Mr. Duncan? No, we don't have to wear our face masks here. But we do have to stay very far from other people. So one of the big rules here in England is we have to stay very far away from other people. And because of that, we don't have to wear our face masks. So that is something we don't have to do. And of course, I'm in the countryside. So I suppose I'm quite lucky because I don't have to actually worry about it because I live in the countryside. So that's where I am at the moment. A lot of people seem very interested to find out where I am. I'm in England. And I will be going in a moment. Thank you very much for your company. Thank you, Arisha. Thank you also to XBlackGacha. Thank you very much. I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. I teach English. I talk about all sorts of subjects. But during this very strange period of time, I am also here to share my time with you and hopefully you with me. Thank you very much for your company. Thank you, everyone. Thanks for watching. I am going now. I've been here. I've just realised. I've been here for 2.5 hours. I can't believe it. I've actually been here for 2.5 hours. Talking to you from the roof of my house. I can't believe it. Anyway, I'm going now. I must go for 2 reasons. 1, I'm very thirsty. And 2, I'm very cold. And 3, I have to go and spend a penny. That's what I have to do now, you see. I have to go and spend a penny. If you've been watching, you will know exactly what I'm talking about. Thank you, Mr. Duncan. Thank you, Hiroko. Thank you. Thank you also to Unicorina. Thank you also to I can see there is a crow behind you. Oh, yes. Can you see? There is a little bird over there sitting on the branch. Oh. He's gone. He just flew away. I think he's very shy. I think that bird is shy. I think so. That's why he flew away. Thanks a lot for your company. Thank you. Thank you, Hwen. Thank you, so many people. I am completely overwhelmed by your company today. Thank you very much for joining me. I'm back tomorrow, 2 p.m. UK time. Give me a thumbs up before I go and put a big smile on my face at the same time. Hello, Noddy or Nodi. Hello, Nodi. Can you please say my name, Nodia? Hello, Nodia. And also goodbye to Nodia because I'm going now. Have a good evening, Mr. Duncan. Goodbye to Martha in Poland. Goodbye to Pappy. Goodbye, Vitas. Oh, my goodness. So many people here today. I don't know where to begin. So many people. See you tomorrow, Mr. Jaffa Cakes man. I will. I will be here tomorrow. And Mr. Steve will be here as well. 2 p.m. UK time tomorrow. And, of course, every day I will be with you here on YouTube during this crazy time. And of course, until tomorrow, see you later. Have a great day. Have a great morning, wherever you are watching in the world. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of the English language, which is, of course, England, saying thanks for watching. Thanks for joining me. And of course, until tomorrow, You know what's coming next. Yes, you do. See you later. Stay safe. And of course, ta-ta for now.